I think we're just going to carry on straight away with our recital now. We're each going to play a couple of pieces. I'm going to play some German and Dutch music, and John is going to play all of the English music, and Mark is going to go to France. First of all, I'm going to play a little chorale prelude by Buxtehude. He was just a predecessor of Bach. He worked virtually all his life as organist at the Marienkirk in Lübeck. He wrote literally thousands of pieces of organ music. We recently visited Lübeck, and the tradition of music goes on even to this day. There's a magnificent organ. In fact, there are two magnificent organs in the church there. And in the summer, they have very regular organ concerts. So the first piece, I thought appropriate, it's Ein fester Berg by Buxtehude to start with. And then following on from that, one of my favorite Dutch composers is a man called Hendrik Andreasen. We often go on holiday to Holland and we enjoy listening to the sounds of the organs in Holland. And Hendrik Andreasen is one of the composers that you often hear in a recital there. This piece is called A Theme and Variations. And I've chosen it, I played it at my recital a couple of weeks ago, but I've chosen it again today because it gives you various colours on the organ. It starts off with a sort of loud introduction and then goes quietly for the theme. You will hear the actual theme that is going to be the variations are based on. And then a set of variations which are loud, soft, and then finally you will hear the same theme as the beginning, the introduction coming in, and you will eventually hear the full sound of the organ. You will hear every stop on the organ sounding at the end, the magnificent sound.
Thank you. said, I'm going to follow on with some English music. We're going to go right back to Baroque period and the music of Purcell first. Now, Purcell's church and instrumental music is very well known, and he was something of a trailblazer with his opera Dido and Aeneas. Of the scant amount of known organ music, the voluntary for double organ is a good example of the toccata-like music written for the best organs of the day, like Westminster Abbey, where he was the organist. This is a dialogue between the great organ and the chair organ. The small division, often seen perched on the edge of an organ gallery, and I never used to want to as a youngster to sit underneath it. Now it's called the choir organ. English organs of this period didn't have pedals, so the extravagance of the piece sort of makes up for it. I'm going to take a very large leap now into the 20th century and the music of Herbert Howells. He wrote three rhapsodies between 1915 and 1918. Number one, in D flat, which is the one I'm going to play, is said to be a musical representation of a place called Chosen Hill in Gloucestershire. But I believe the First World War's impact is very clear in the drama in this music.
Now it's my turn to play you some pieces from France. I heard something today which might amuse you with all the problems with submarines and things. Apparently there's the last one of the series the Royal Navy are going to put forward into the sea is called HMS Agincourt. However, in France, after the French Revolution, all the early organs were destroyed because of the French Revolution. So all the pipes were hacked away and they were melted down and made into lead shot during the Revolution. So after the French Revolution, when things started settling down, all the churches, these were open and they had no organs in them. By that time, we were in the early 19th century, and music itself had become much more orchestral in texture and much more romantic. So the old Baroque organs were lost forever. And in France, there was a huge amount of change in the French churches with these huge organs that are still today in the cathedrals and particularly all the large churches in Paris. And during that time in the 19th century, there were a lot of composers who were composer organists and taught in the Paris Conservatoire. And so I'm playing you a couple of pieces today. One is by César Franck, a pastoral, and the other is somebody, a sort of flashy toccata by someone called Theodore Dubois. So that they should be quite contrasting pieces. The first one is very pastoral in its nature, has a storm in the middle, and the second piece is very bright, but has a quiet central section and then a recapitulation at the end. There are a lot of quite famous toccatas that people play from the French repertoire, but it's definitely French romantic.